Hi folks, in this unit we'll look at the topic of scaling. Scaling is the study of how different aspects of a system change as the size of the system increases. It turns out that complex systems often scale in ways that are surprising and in many cases not well understood. Here we'll look at some fascinating and somewhat controversial results on scaling in biology. And then we'll take a brief look at some very new work on scaling in cities. Let's start. The field of scaling asks how attributes of a system change as the system size increases. For example, in biology, we might ask how attributes of organisms change as their body mass increases. Or in urban scaling, a very popular area nowadays, we might ask how attributes of cities change as their population increases. The study of scaling has been very important in the research community in complex systems because many clues to how complex systems work can be gained by studying how these systems scale. There's one simple mathematical concept which is very important to understanding scaling, and that's the concept of proportionality. Here's the symbol of proportionality here. And the quantity y is said to be proportional to the quantity x if y is equal to some constant c, that is some number, times x. For example, here's a proportionality relationship. Y is equal to 2x. Every time x is increased, y is increased by double the amount. Or here's another example. Y is equal to minus 1/3 x. That is, say that x increases from 1 to 2, then y will decrease from minus 1/3 to minus 2/3. Proportionality is a linear relationship. You can see that that is true because these formulas represent straight lines. Let's look at the notion of scaling in a very simple context, that of geometric scaling. Suppose you want to move from your current small bedroom to a larger bedroom. Here's your current bedroom. It has a certain length to the room, and the new bedroom has twice that length. So now, you ask, how big a bed can I fit into my new room? Well, the length of a bed you can fit scales linearly with the length of the room. That is, you have a particular length of bed in your old room. Now you can fit twice that length of bed in your new room. So we can say that here, bed length is proportional to room length. And you can plot it like this. Where as room length gets bigger, the size of the bed you can fit scales in this linear way. Now that's a very simple example. Let's suppose now that you have a rug in your original room. Now you can get a bigger rug for your new room. How much bigger? Well, the area of the rug you can now fit in your new room scales in a way that's quadratic with the length of the room. Quadratic means as the square of. Since area scales with the square of length, the area of the rug you can fit scales with the square of the room length. If you double the size of the room, that means that you quadruple the square feet or square meters of the rug that can fill the room because 2 squared is 4. Here's what the plot looks like for quadratic scaling. You can see that as the room length is increased, the rug area goes up much faster than in the linear scaling case. Finally, if the bedroom belongs to a teenager, if you have a teenager or if you are a teenager, you might be the kind of teenager who likes to pile your laundry up to the ceiling. I used to be that kind of teenager myself, and now I'm the mother of one. As you get a bigger room, you can pile more and more laundry up to the ceiling. How does that scale with the length of your room? Well, the volume of laundry you can pile up to the ceiling scales cubically with the length of the room. That is, the volume of laundry is proportional to the room length cubed. That's because volume scales as length cubed. And you can see that by looking at this plot. The volume of laundry goes up very quickly as the room length increases. So if you double the size of your room, then you'd be able to fit 8 times the amount of laundry, because 8 is 2 cubed. In general, many attributes have what we've called power law scaling. You learned about power laws in the networks section of this course. And here the idea is that some attribute, such as volume or area, is proportional to size, here we were using room length, to the power of some constant alpha. Now notice the notation. This is the proportionality symbol, and this is the Greek letter alpha, the exponent here. Alpha is a constant, so just remember that these are two different symbols. This means that our attribute, such as volume of laundry, is equal to some constant, C, times the size raised to some power, alpha. Okay, where both C and alpha are constants. And we can write that in terms of y and x as y equals c times x to the alpha. This is what's called a power law.